A production of Kentucky State University Aquaculture.
Okay, so this is cirrhosis we performed yesterday. And now, first of all, you see that now much less bubbles. As I said, bubbles usually from the beginning. Now it's mostly there. This is normal condition of incubation. You see, eggs slowly moving. And also, you see now that part of eggs white, as I said. So this is here, we saw that kind of based off, it was hard to determine exactly to count, but we saw that here was the most of X, only fraction was not fertilized. And you see here more white X. So at that stage, all unfertilized X already white. So it's big difference with yesterday. So visually, without microscope, all of X have been transparent. But now they already unfertilized eggs white. So now we continue observe development of mass production of koi. We performed spawning and artificial insemination on Wednesday. During several days, actually I said that in general, 3 days incubation, 3 days embryonic development, and after hatching, in another 3 days for larvae to swim up. So hatching started afternoon Saturday. Actually, the speed of development depending on temperature. Here temperature was about 21 degrees C. So on Saturday, hatching started and only started, and on Sunday actually it was kind of mass hatching. Today on Monday, hatching almost completed, but you see here, so here, actually here what is left here on in just, you see that when they hatched, they swim up actively and swim out from incubation just in harpers. Here left some larvae which morphologically abnormal, and simply some of them will continue to swim out. You can see here. And you can also you can see in harpers large amount of larvae. Okay. So now I will put some larvae in beaker and explain more in detail, describe hatch larvae of koi. First of all, in this beaker, you see koi larvae. First of all, you can see that this larvae, body larvae, is not pigmented. Pigmented only larvae eyes. This is typical for koi. Therefore, they have a kind of light yellowish body. And also, you can see actually. I would say that it's at this stage larvae cannot regulate their position in water. Actually, they actively swim up, and after that they passively sink. So this is character of their movement, because now larvae do not have swim bladder. It takes, as I said, about 3 days when swim bladder appears and larvae will start really swim to control their position in the water. You can see here how they swim up and sink down. So we spawn koi on Wednesday last week. It was April 23rd. Today Thursday next week. Today the 1st of May. So it's kind of 8 days later. So now you will see results, actually final report on koi spawning in this demonstration. So last time I showed here it was kind of finishing of hatching, and in McDonald's jars, after all viable larvae they swam out, it left some unhatched embryos and also morphologically abnormal. So I cleaned McDonald's jars, and in 3 days actually, now they already swam up, all larvae. Actually they swam up yesterday, so today we plan to stock them for further rearing in tanks or in ponds. So now I will show you how looks like larvae which already swam up. You can see now that larvae have swim bladder, small air bubble. With its help, actually larvae can regulate their position in water, and they can really swim So it's mean, actually, as I said, the special term swimming up. And now they are ready, as I said, they are ready to be stopped. So now, after actually one day after swimming up, they already kind of, they are ready to eat, to transfer to external feeding. So how, and also you can see that koi larvae, the very visible eyes, they are pigmented, but body is unpigmented, it is light yellow color. This is koi larvae, ready to be stocked.